Today we will start the new chapter of political and social life, that is chapter 3, the parliamentary form of government. The constitution states that India has a parliamentary form of government. So our Indian constitution, it says that our India, or you can say our Indian government, is a parliamentary form of government. The government has three distinct organs. So our government is divided into three important organs, and they are the executive, the legislature, and the judiciary. The parliament is the legislative body of the government. So the parliament, which is present in our country India, is at New Delhi, and the parliament is a legislative body of our Indian government. The executive, that means the first organ of the Indian government, comprises the president, the prime minister, and the council of ministers. So who all are there in the executive section? They are the president, the prime minister, and the council of ministers. In India, the executive is accountable to the legislature. So in our India, the executive, that means the president, the prime minister, and the council of ministers, they are accountable to the legislature. That means they have to give answer to the government that if they are doing any illegal activities, or if they wanted to implement any law, or if they want to bring new laws in our country, they have to first answer to the legislature. That means the both Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, because they are the most important houses which plays an important role to make a law in our country. So that's why the executive, that means the president, the prime minister, and the council of minister, they have to answer to the legislature. The prime minister and his council of ministers are members of the parliament. So who all are the members of the parliament? They are the prime minister and his council of ministers. So why parliamentary form of government? Why in India there is parliamentary form of government? Let us find out. The framers of the constitution choose the parliamentary form of government for India because they realize that the success of democracy depends on the participation of people in the governance of the country. So why we, that means our, the makers of Indian constitution, they have used, or they have choose only parliamentary form of government for India, because the framers, or the persons, or you can say group of people who had made the Indian constitution, they realized that if in order to make democracy successful in our country, the term democracy means that it is a country where the people have the right to vote in an election, okay, and they can vote after it once they are 18 years and or above, okay. So that procedure is known as democracy. That means giving the right to vote to every individual, whether they are Hindu, Muslim, or any religion, or whether they are from higher section or lower section, doesn't matter, in a democratic form of government. So our framers, they have realized that in order to make democracy successful in our country, it basically depend upon the participation of people. That means if people will not participate in an election through the voting rights, then the parliamentary form of government will not work properly. So this is the main reason why the framers of the Indian constitution, they have choose parliamentary form of government, because so that the people, whether they are living in any part of our country, they can participate in our country, and hence our leaders are the representative of the citizen of our country. We choose our own leader, right? How? With the help of election, by giving our valuable votes. So that's why we have, or you can say the framers of the Indian constitution, they have chosen parliamentary form of government. In a vast country like India, it is not possible for all the citizens to participate in governance directly and individually. So as we already know, our country is spread in a large area, right? So it is not possible for each and every individual to participate in the governance, okay? That's why we that means there is a representative, that means a leader will be there who will stand behalf of the citizen of our country, and he or she will rule the country. So they would need to elect representatives who would act on their behalf. These representatives form the parliament. So I have already told you that the representative will stand on behalf of the people who will participate in an election, and whichever party get as number of votes, that party, that means that representative will form the parliament. In a parliamentary form of government, since the executive is a member of the parliament can always keep on check on the powers of the executive. So, emergence of a dictator is unlikely. So, in a parliamentary form of government, okay, the executive, that means the prime minister, the president, and the council of ministers, they are the members of the parliament, okay. So they are the members of the parliament. So they can, you can say, check the powers and functions of any members of the parliament. That means if they are doing any illegal activities, they can directly go and check. And if they are doing any activities which are against our constitution, they can even be punished by the Supreme Court of our India. So that's why the executive, which are the member of the parliament, they can check the powers of other executive. For example, prime minister can check the powers of the Lok Sabha members and the Rajya Sabha members, or the Supreme Court powers, or the High Court powers. So that's why the parliamentary form of government plays an important role, so that they can check the powers of each executive. Why this power is given? So that there will be no dictator in our country. That means monarchy system will not be implemented or be applied in our country. So that's why these features is implemented in the parliamentary form of government in India. Many of the leaders who were involved in framing of the constitution were familiar with the working of the parliamentary system in Britain. So the leaders who had made the constitution of India, they knew that what was the positive and negative aspect of the parliamentary system. Why? Because they were working under the British government in Britain. They wanted a similar system for independent India. So as they wanted India to be independent, that's why they have used, or they have taken these features, that is the parliamentary form of government from Britain, and it implemented or it added in our Indian constitution.